The first game on our list is Ghost Runner, and let me tell you, it is quite an ambitious title. It features fast-moving ninja action, where you parkour your way through environments and slash enemies with your lethal sword. However, there's a twist. You're extremely fragile, and a single hit can bring you down. So you'll need to strategize and work hard to survive in this game. Now, I played Ghost Runner on both the Switch and my high-end PC, and one challenge I faced was managing where I was looking at any given time. If angled incorrectly, your wall jumps and runs won't work smoothly, making it difficult to keep track of your enemies as you move quickly. Although the developers did a remarkable job of getting this game to run well on the Switch, there were some sacrifices made in terms of visuals and detail, which can be a bit wonky at times. Next up, we have Astral Chain, a visually stunning game with fantastic presentation and deep, rewarding combat. Developed by Platinum Games, this might just be their most accomplished game yet. It combines detective work with exhilarating battle sequences that are both challenging and incredibly cool. Now, the complexity of the game's systems might seem intimidating to some players. However, the inclusion of co-op play and the option to automate certain mechanics through the Unchained mode makes it accessible even for newcomers. While Astral Chain doesn't reach 60 FPS levels of smoothness, the performance in handheld and docked modes is solid and reliable, ensuring that combat feels intuitive and seamless. There might be occasional slowdowns, especially in handheld mode, but they don't detract from the overall intensity of the game. Keep in mind that compared to the PS4 and Xbox One, Astral Chain may look slightly last-gen, but it sets a new high watermark for the Switch. Hyrule Warriors: Age of Calamity. Now, it's important to note that this is not a traditional Zelda game, but a Zelda-infused Musou experience with a sparkling presentation. It offers varied and satisfying combat, along with additions from Breath of the Wild that blend beautifully with the Warriors template. The attention to detail in this game is truly impressive. While the performance is adequate and doesn't hinder your enjoyment, be prepared for some slowdowns, especially in two-player co-op when things get explosive. However, Hyrule Warriors: Age of Calamity provides a great opportunity to revisit the beloved world and characters from Breath of the Wild and unleash your sword-wielding skills on the prowling enemies. God Eater 3. This game takes hack and slash to a whole new level with its unique burst art special attack. These moves allow your weapon to grow an actual mouth and take a bite out of your enemies. Talk about a dramatic way to deal some major damage. Whether you prefer playing solo with AI companions or joining forces with up to 3 other players locally or online, God Eater 3 offers an awesome team-based battle experience. And with the support for 8-player raid-style missions, you can really take on some epic challenges as part of a bigger team. And let's not forget the assault missions, which are a great way to team up with a friend in co-op. With God Eater 3 being a port to the Nintendo Switch, there may be a slight downgrade in visuals, but don't worry. It doesn't take away from the overall enjoyment of the game. It runs incredibly well, with only a few rare instances of slowdown, especially when playing online. Next up, we have Dead Cells: Return to Castlevania. This DLC is an absolute treat for fans of both the Dead Cells and Castlevania series. The marriage of these two intense and beloved games is simply fantastic. The Castlevania stage outside the castle walls is a great addition, and it's easily accessible, unlike some other DLCs. Once you're in, get ready to be impressed by classic cuts from the series and some amazing remixes that will take you on a trip down memory lane. Your quest in this DLC is to take on Dracula, but be warned, it won't be an easy task. The challenge of reaching him, let alone surviving his aggressive attacks, adds an extra layer of excitement. With the inclusion of classic characters, enemies, and weapons that seamlessly integrate into the gameplay, there's really nothing to complain about. This DLC is a perfect excuse to return to this top-tier title in the Switch library. Devil May Cry 3. Capcom has outdone themselves with this new Switch edition by adding a brand new freestyle mode. This mode allows you to switch between different combat styles on the fly, opening up a whole new world of combos and strategies. And that's not all. This edition also introduces local co-op for the Blood Palace challenge rooms. Now you can team up with a friend and take on the challenges together, with one player controlling Dante and the other playing as Virgil. These new additions make an already immensely entertaining and replayable game even better. Despite being 15 years old, Devil May Cry 3 still holds up with its fast and furious combat. The camera may have its quirks at times, and there's a bit of backtracking, but it's all worth it for the amazing combat experience. And let's not forget about Dante's character. With his cocky attitude and flashy moves, he's a joy to watch. The voice acting in this game is also top-notch, adding to the over-the-top and action-packed cutscenes. Devil May Cry 3 on the Nintendo Switch is definitely the ultimate version of this timeless action game. Now, No More Heroes 3 is a game that may have a few flaws, but it definitely doesn't disappoint. This blood-soaked, over-the-top carnage fest is a love letter to excess and a true treat for fans of the series. While it may not reach the heights of its Wii origins, the cool story and impressive gameplay make up for it. The visuals are striking, although the frame rate does dip a bit in the open world. But that doesn't take away from the game's ability to keep us hooked with its twisty-turny narrative. And let's not forget the awesome victory music when we conquer a designated match. Next up, we have The Wonderful 101 Remastered. Now, this game oozes personality and style, and it's clear that a lot of effort went into its development. The action-oriented gameplay takes a unique approach, allowing you to form objects with your team of heroes to fight enemies and navigate through the game. However, the transition from the Wii U's dual screens to the Switch's single screen does cause a bit of a mess. The cluttered screen and wonky gestures can make for an uneven experience. But despite these challenges, The Wonderful 101 still manages to bring some real positives to the table and offers a flashy, action-packed adventure. Katana Zero, a game that you absolutely need in your Switch collection. This side-scrolling action game is a true gem with intense action sequences, a gripping narrative, and impeccable style. It sets new standards for what this genre can achieve. While it may have a relatively low runtime of around 10 hours, every level is expertly crafted, ensuring a consistently high-quality experience. This game gets right to the point and knows when to bow out without any filler content. It's refreshing to play a game that focuses on delivering a killer experience from start to finish. Persona 5 Strikers, a game that brings all the action and drama of Persona 5 to the Switch. This port runs smoothly, with great visuals and minimal bugs. The only downside is the lack of anti-aliasing, but it doesn't hinder the overall experience. In both docked and handheld modes, the gameplay is clear and easy to follow, and the stylish menus add a satisfying touch. Although the game has a few flaws, like the need for grinding and some camera issues, it's still a highly successful spin-off with a strong story and flashy action. Fans of the franchise and action RPGs in general will definitely enjoy it. Next up, we have Ultra Age, a game that offers a good balance of challenge and innovative ideas. While the voice acting may not be the best, once you dive into the gameplay, things start to get interesting. Swapping between different blade types, hunting for crystals, and customizing skills to match your slashing style adds depth to the experience. Yes, your blades will degrade with use, but shattering them against enemies for massive damage makes up for it. Though it may not be as polished as other hack and slash games, the affordable price makes it a fair compromise. And the fact that there's a demo available is a great bonus for players to try it out. Overall, Ultra Age is a commendable effort in the hack and slash genre, especially considering the limited options available in the indie scene. Bayonetta 3. This threequel takes the incredible combat mechanics from the first two games and elevates them to a whole new level. The addition of summoning infernal demons as sidekicks doesn't disrupt the tight combos and witch time magic that fans love. It actually enhances the experience, adding a new layer of madness and excitement. Calling upon giant monsters and powerful entities to aid you in battle is a game changer. It may take some time to get used to, but once you master it, you'll be hooked. Platinum Games has truly outdone themselves with Bayonetta 3. The combat has never been better, and it's a must-play for any hack-and-slash enthusiast. Darksiders Genesis. This game takes the series to new heights with its satisfying hack and slash action and expansive levels filled with secrets, puzzles, and platforming. The fully co-op campaign and unlockable arena mode provide hours of entertainment for both fans of the series and newcomers alike. However, the Switch version does suffer from some minor blurriness and FPS hiccups in portable mode. Despite these issues, the game is still highly enjoyable, especially when replaying levels and mastering the battle areas. It's a shame that the resolution couldn't be fixed at 720p in handheld mode, but hopefully, a patch arrives soon to improve the overall experience. Considering the limitations of the portable platform, it's quite impressive that Darksiders Genesis is even on the Switch. Next up, we have Torchlight 2. This game is designed to be played multiple times with different characters, similar to a roguelike. The core gameplay loop is so addictive that any missed opportunities for M-in and maxing can easily be overlooked. Unlike its predecessor, Torchlight 2 offers a vast, partially randomized open world that encourages exploration and rewards you with loot and secret dungeons. Each segmented map is filled with quests, enemies, and NPCs, creating an unpredictable and compelling experience. Whether you stumble upon a slaving troop or unlock a multi-floor dungeon, there's always something interesting to do. So get ready to dive deep into the world of Torchlight 2 and grow your character's skills while collecting valuable loot. Attack on Titan 2. In addition to the gripping story mode, this game offers an another mode with online functionality for teaming up with other players to take down Titans. You can respond to SOS requests, trade resources, and even compete against other Slayers in a race to eliminate as many Titans as possible. Playing with other players adds a dynamic element to the Titan battles and enhances the overall experience. However, there are some occasional slowdown issues, particularly in handheld mode when there are multiple characters on screen. While this can be frustrating, it doesn't break the game, and the intense action against those pesky titans is still very enjoyable. Children of Morta is a challenging top-down dungeon-crawling game with a stunning art style. It features multiple character classes, each with their own unique feel and playstyle. The game offers a run-to-run progression system, where you'll face risks and rewards, as well as unpredictable encounters. But what sets this game apart for me is the captivating story that unfolds as you progress. It revolves around family themes and really enhances your connection to the game and its characters. This level of care is rare in the genre, making Children of Morta one of the top-tier roguelike games out there. If you're up for a challenging and rewarding experience, this game is definitely worth checking out. School, the Hero Slayer, takes a simple approach to the genre. You don't have a plethora of skills to use, but instead, your attacks are dictated by the head you equip. This adds an element of unpredictability to each run, as the type of head you get can drastically change your playstyle. Furthermore, the game's meta progression is not as extensive as other titles, but it stays true to the roguelike spirit of learning from mistakes, improving your skills, and overcoming challenges. While it can be frustrating at times, especially in the beginning, once you get the hang of it, Skull, the Hero Slayer becomes a thrilling and teeth-gritting experience. So if you're a fan of challenging side-scrolling slashers, this game is definitely worth a try. Fire Emblem Warriors. Three Hopes is an entertaining mashup of Musou Mayhem, strategy, and relationship building aspects. It improves upon its 2017 predecessor by offering a more engaging story that invites repeated playthroughs. With solid performance on the Nintendo Switch and a thrilling campaign that spans over 30 hours, this game is a must-play for fans of both the Fire Emblem and Warriors franchises. The battles in Three Hopes are action-packed and strategic. You'll lead your squad through maps filled with countless foes and face-boss battles inspired by Fire Emblem. The game also introduces features like recruiting defeated enemy commanders and calling in battalions of hired goons for added tactical depth. Additionally, you can engage in relationship building, leveling up, improving facilities, forging weapons, cooking, training, and more.
Take a breather.
Darksiders 3. This latest entry in the Darksiders series brings the story of the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse to the Switch. In this game, you'll be playing as Fury, the lone female horseman, who has a different combat style compared to her brothers. Fury is more agile and relies on her whip for traversal and technique-driven combat. While I appreciate the level design and exploration, there is one drawback, the lack of a map, which can lead to getting lost and wasting time. Additionally, the visuals and performance of the game on the Switch seem to push the console's limitations a bit, with some noticeable cracks. Despite these issues, fans of the Darksiders series should still enjoy this entry, especially if they don't have access to another platform to play it on. Next up, we have Hades, a roguelike game that truly stands out with its narrative. The game features amazingly well-written and acted characters, including various gods from Greek mythology. The story unfolds at its own pace, keeping you hooked through the relationship between the protagonist Zagros and his father Hades. Alongside the engaging story, the game also incorporates a dating simulator-esque element where you can enhance your relationships with other characters through conversation and gifts. This downtime between escape attempts is actually enjoyable, rather than just being menu screens and stats. Hades really excels in both combat and storytelling, making it a must-play on the Nintendo Switch. Diablo 3, Eternal Collection. Whether you're playing in docked or handheld mode, the game performs smoothly and looks good. However, the console implementation of menus might take some getting used to, and there's a chance that important features may be missed if you're new to the game. Diablo 3 offers a vast variety of combat approaches, a wide range of enemies and bosses to face, and endless activities to do even after completing the main story. The fact that you can now take all of this on the go with the Switch is impressive, showcasing the capabilities of both the system and the development team.
Patience.
Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3, The Black Order. Now, this game may have a few minor issues, but overall it's a really enjoyable experience. It brings back the nostalgia of classic SNES / Mega Drive games like Captain America and the Avengers. The best part is that you can play solo, locally with a friend, or even online with up to three other players. It's great to see this familiar gameplay formula fitting into the gaming landscape of 2019. Plus, being a Nintendo Switch exclusive, it runs smoothly, even with four players on the screen. The character models may have some jagged edges, but the cartoonish visuals make up for it. Marvel fans will definitely love this game, and it's a perfect choice for some silly and over-the-top arcade brawling action. Nier Automata, a modern classic. And for all you Switch owners out there, you'll be happy to know that this is an outstanding port. The visuals and performance are beyond expectations. Playing this game on the Switch with a comfortable seat and a good pair of headphones is a wonderful experience. The story and gameplay will keep you engaged, and it's truly one of the finest gaming achievements of the last decade. The port runs at a solid 30 frames per second, and the team at Virtuos has done a fantastic job. The world, although sparsely populated at times, looks stunning on the Switch. Some sacrifices had to be made in terms of textures and asset streaming, but overall, it feels like a native title rather than a struggling port. Titan Quest. Now, to fully appreciate this game, a historical perspective and a touch of nostalgia are recommended. The core loop of battling creatures and finding rare loot is as addictive as ever. However, the visuals may have a few glitches and occasional crashes, but that doesn't stop the fun. The Switch's handheld mode is a massive advantage for any RPG, and this port delivers the core experience well. In terms of performance, it may not be the best, but it's definitely playable. There are some drops in frame rate, especially in enclosed spaces, and you may notice some pop-in textures and terrain. But overall, it's still a decent-looking game with some nice shadow effects and pleasing water visuals. Handheld mode does soften the image a bit, and the screen text may be a bit small, but that shouldn't deter you from enjoying this game on the go.
Feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind? Please, Lord, give me a sign, a sign. I feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind?